So for this video, I'd like to consider the use of a PIR when controlling a lighting circuit. So what a PIR stands for is passive infrared. And so basically what that is, it's a detector that detects heat from the objects that passes through its field. And so it's basically just a switch. So rather than having a manual switch that you just turn on or off, the PIR does the switching for you. We have a circuit breaker or a fuse. So we've got the PIR and we have the actual lights here. So the first thing to think about with a PIR, generally there's four connections. There's usually a supply live connection, a switch live connection, and then there's usually two neutral connections, but both of those neutral connections are linked together. So I'm just going to draw it as one here. So the first thing to think about is the neutrals. So on this lighting circuit, there's obviously going to be a neutral going to the PIR. And so that's all I'm going to draw it there. I'm not actually going to draw it in the circuit. And also on the actual lights as well, there will also be a neutral going to there. There will also be a CPC, but I'm not going to draw those in this one. So basically, we've got the circuit breaker, which simply take a live feed to the PIR, which again, as you can see, is just a switch. And then another feed going to the lights. And that's how a basic PIR lighting circuit is connected up. Remember, the PIR has got electronic equipment inside. So the more lights you have, the more load is being switched through the PIR. So it's not really a great idea to have too many lights or too much load on the PIR. Where could this circuit be used? Well, I've installed it in people's houses before in a garage or a shed or in a utility room. Just as you walk in, you could be carrying, say for example, in a utility room, you're walking in with a handful of washing. Rather than having to turn on a light switch, you can have a PIR either mounted on the wall or in the ceiling, and that picks you up and the lights turn on without you having to do anything. PIRs also do have a couple of controls on them. They have a time setting for when they, how long they're going to stay on for. So usually, a minimum of maybe 5 seconds up to about sort of a couple of minutes. And they also have daylight and nighttime settings, but that's all relatively straightforward. But the main thing is for this video is just to understand the basic wiring for it. And as you can see, you don't get too much more basic than what this is. Following on from the basic lighting circuit for a PIR, I've now introduced a one-way switch. And the idea of a one-way switch is basically an override switch. So again, all we have to do here is take a live feed. So the permanent live feed here will come to this one, to the top of the switch. And then we'll take another feed from the switch feed from the PIR down to here. And as you can see, that's just two switches in parallel with one another. And it's just an override switch. So this can now work in one of two ways. You can have the normal PIR operating. So in this position, the PIR will be operating. So as soon as something is detected, heat is detected, the switch will close. And so electricity will flow through here, through the switch and to the lights, and the lights will turn on. Now, the only issue is if the PIR has only been set to operate for, say, maybe 10 seconds, and you've got this in a situation where you might want to be in the place for more than 10 seconds, you can do one of two things. You can either operate the PIR, you can either adjust the PIR to last longer, or you can do a manual, install a manual override switch. And all this is just a one-way switch. So as you can see now, if we was to operate the switch, and I was just to close it like so, now what we have done is that we have overridden the PIR. So basically, the connection is now through here to the PIR, all the way through, down into the switch, through the switch, back up, through the switch live connection, and then back to the lights, and now the lights will stay on. And so that's relatively quite simple. Notice that we always have a permanent live supply going to the PIR. It's important that the PIR always has a permanent live supply going to it. You never want to switch the permanent live supply. The reason being is that these have got all various electronic equipment inside that needs to be reset sometimes. And so if you keep cutting the power to the PIR, then that will cause various issues. One thing that I should have mentioned previously as well is that the size of the circuit breaker obviously needs to reflect on the amount of lights that are going to be there. So normally this would probably be a 6-amp light, and normally a 6-amp circuit breaker for the lights, but then you'd have to consider how many lights you are going to have. So I don't know, you might just have two or three fluorescent lights or LEDs or whatever they are, and usually this circuit here would be okay. So hopefully that video will be useful for someone.